Day two of the International Builder Show. I started my day off bright and early here at the Huber booth for a press conference. These guys brought in Joe Stiebrich, the godfather of building science. I always love hearing Joe speak, and it was so fun to have him come out for that press breakfast. I also scored a great interview with Joe. So if you're not familiar with Huber, though, I first met these guys about 10 years ago. I had some subfloor in a house that got fairly wet, and that plywood, even though I spent a bunch of money for it, delaminated and caused a problem in a house. And that's when I first learned about their Advantech sheathing. Been using it now for 10 years, and I've never looked back. That's all I use is Advantech decking. Some great products. But today, I want to talk to you about a couple of new things at their booth, especially because the codes have changed for so many builders out there. And with the advent of the 2015 International Residential Codes, now most parts of the U.S. are requiring exterior rigid foam, and builders are looking for solutions. And Zip has really delivered with this Zip System R sheathing. New this year, they've got four different flavors. You can get their insulated sheathing now in half inch all the way up to 2 inch varieties. And now we're going to be able to meet the code for all those different climate zones with one of those four flavors. But also new this year is you can fasten this with pneumatic fasteners, and they've got the engineered code reports, so you can just hand that to your inspector to say, hey, we've nailed it with this fastener that meets these dimensions and with this spacing, and now the sheathing on my house that's already insulated, it's just like I'm used to using with Zip. Super easy. It's going to meet the codes. It's also going to give me that shear value I need. Another big theme that I've seen at the Builder Show this year has been resiliency. So let's go check out another part of their booth where they're talking about that. I love talking about durability. And the theme that I mentioned, that resiliency that I'm seeing from a lot of manufacturers, really fits right in with that. Manufacturers are trying to show how their products can really help a house out if a big storm happens. And I love this display at the Huber booth. Think about this. A huge storm comes. That wind whips those shingles right off the roof. If you don't have a fully applied underlayment like this, think how much water would come in on that seam of that plywood as it comes together. That house would absolutely get soaked. I like talking about roofs as an umbrella over the house. If I've got a raincoat on and then an umbrella up, my umbrella gets a big rip like that seam right there in the roof, think how much water is going to come down my head. I'm going to get soaked even though I've got a raincoat on. There's some really big deals happening right now throughout the industry, especially in coastal areas as we think about resiliency, including states like Alabama that have adopted some codes that are really beyond the national building code. The insurance companies have gotten together, they've figured out some great standards, how to keep that roof on the house from blowing off, how to keep that water out even if shingles blow off. This is some good stuff. For more on this topic, you can visit zipsystem.com/roof. Thanks for joining me at the Huber Booth. We'll see you next year at IBS 2018.